In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy and function of posterior part of hip muscles. I will not go too much detail about each muscle. I will explain general anatomy and function. Let's get started with this big muscle. This is gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus. It originates from pelvis and sacrum. It's about here and it attaches to fascia and femur. Simply, it's from pelvis and it goes to thigh, femur. Okay, this is the biggest muscle in human body. General function of gluteus maximus is hip extension. Hip extension. You use hip extension for walking, running, and jump. It's strong joint mover. Extension is general function. One more thing, that is external rotation. External rotation. These two movements are general function of gluteus maximus. By the way, you can divide gluteus maximus to two parts. This pink part is upper fiber. This yellow part is lower fiber. Actually, upper fiber can do abduction. Abduction is you open up leg. You bring leg to lateral way. This is abduction. On the other hand, lower fiber can do adduction. Adduction is you close leg this way. It's interesting, right? Upper fiber does abduction. Lower fiber does adduction. It's completely opposite function. It depends on where your fiber is. Your function is gonna be completely opposite. It's very interesting. General function is extension and external rotation. Upper fiber, abduction. Lower fiber, adduction. Let's go to next muscle. Now, gluteus maximus is removed. Let's focus on this one. This is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius, it attaches to pelvis. It originates from pelvis and it inserts to femur, greater trochanter. General function of gluteus medius is abduction. Now you know what kind of movement abduction is, right? You open up leg to lateral way. This is abduction. And you can divide gluteus medius to two parts, like gluteus maximus, like this. Anterior part and posterior part. Oh, it's gonna be very detailed function. Anterior fiber can do flexion and internal rotation. Flexion and internal rotation. Think about it. If anterior fiber contracts this way, that can bring to flexion and internal rotation. Then when posterior fiber contracts, that's gonna bring it to opposite direction. That's extension and external rotation. Extension and external rotation. See, this muscle is so important for hip movement. Oh, by the way, it is important for hip stabilization. Then, deep to gluteus medius, there is gluteus minimus. You don't see that because this is deep to gluteus medius. Function of gluteus minimus is identical to gluteus medius. Okay, I am talking about gluteus minimus now, okay? Gluteus minimus. It is same function as gluteus medius. We looked at three gluteal muscles. Gluteus maximus, the biggest one. Extension, external rotation, abduction, adduction. Gluteus medius, middle size of glutes muscle. Then gluteus minimus, the smallest gluteal muscle. They are so important for hip movement. Then let's go to even deeper part. You see these tiny muscles? These muscles are called deep lateral rotators. Deep lateral rotator. Or it's called lateral rotator. Well, let's get started with this one. This is piriformis. Piriformis. How about these two muscles? Shape of these two muscles are identical. It's very similar shape. Thus, this is gemellus muscle. The superior one is gemellus superior. Gemellus superior. If there is superior, there should be inferior. This is gemellus inferior. Gemellus means gemina. That means twins, right? So ancient people named these muscles like, oh, they are so identical. Let's name these muscles as gemellae. It makes sense. It's so identical. Then what about this one? This muscle originates from inside of pelvis. Then there is membrane called obturator membrane. Obturator membrane. Thus, this muscle is obturator internus. Obturator internus. If there is internus, there should be externus. But you don't see obturator externus in this picture, so I will talk about that muscle at last part. Okay, obturator internus. What about this one? What is the name of this muscle? Shape of this muscle is kind of rectangular. So this is quadratus femoris. Quadratus. Quadratus means rectangular shape. So makes sense. Its shape is like quadratus, rectangular. Then it's related to femur. Quadratus femoris. Then, what is general function of these muscles? That is, of course, external rotation. External rotation of hip, because name of this muscle group is deep lateral rotator. Lateral rotation means external rotation. That makes sense. Piriformis, gemellus superior, obturator internus, gemellus inferior, and quadratus femoris. There's one more left over, that is obturator externus, which is this one. This is anterior view of hip joint. This is posterior view. You don't see externus, right? This is obturator externus. Obturator internus originates from inside of pelvis. Obturator externus originates from outside of pelvis. This is so important thing. Tightness of obturator externus and internus may affect tension of inside of pelvis. So important muscle groups. Then, what about function of obturator externus? What is general function? That is, of course, external rotation. External rotation, right? So, name of these muscles is deep lateral rotators. General function is external rotation. Actually, each muscle can do slight different function like extension or adduction. But I want you to memorize general function is external rotation. In today's video, I explained muscles that are on posterior part of hip and pelvis. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment and subscribe. See you next video.